Always consult your physician or healthcare provider before beginning any new exercise program. If you experience chest pain or shortness of breath while exercising, call 911. While exercising, you should never feel pain. If you do, stop what you are doing immediately. Don't get discouraged. Just about any exercise can be modified. Begin any new exercise program with moderation and patience in mind. Beginning slowly and increasing the amount as well as the intensity of the exercise over time will give you the most benefit. And remember, drink plenty of water before, during, and after exercising. We're back in the studio, and I'm here with our staff. We've got Verlinda, who's a staff at the center, and we've got Miyuki, who's an intern from Salem State. We've got a lot of wonderful help at the Senior Center on 68 Elm Street. If you haven't been there, come in and take a tour with us. It's a great place to be. We've got lots of good programs starting and continuing. So we're going to do a little warm-up in the chair and then some upper body work in the chair. And then we're going to get up and do some leg work and a little bit of cardiovascular. So you do what you can. Do part of it or all of it. But don't just sit there and watch us. Participate. Okay? So here we go. Let's sit on the edge of our chair. And we're just going to take a deep breath in and exhale. And again, deep breath in through the nose if you can, and exhale through your mouth. And one more time, and exhale. Now let's roll the shoulders back. Two, three, and one more time. And then reverse direction. So really exaggerate your movements. And you're sitting tall, you're letting your abdominals work. So you're pulling them in, letting them keep you up nice and tall. Okay, let's shoulder shrug and relax. Squeeze and relax. Two more times. Just warming up the shoulders here and relax. And again. And so while we're doing the shoulders, why don't we go into a nice big arm circle. One arm back and then the other. And breathe. Back. And back. Let's do two more this way. And again. Remember, just do what you can. Let's go forward with the right arm. And the left. And the right. Left. Two more times on each side. There's lots of ways to modify. If this bothers you, if you have bad shoulders or you've had some surgery done, you can modify. Okay. And let's just warm up the neck. So up and down. Forward and up. Four. Three. One. How about we go right and left? Just turn, center, turn, and center. Just warming up the neck muscles. Good. Let's do a few more. One more on each side. And how about we now start tapping? So just kind of warming up the ankles now, right? Still sitting tall. Get those shoulders back and down. Good. Let's keep tapping. And so the first segment's going to be about maybe 10 more minutes. And then we're going to take a break, get a drink of water. And let's go out and in. Out and in. Beats a little fast, but that's okay. We can do it. And then the second segment, we're going to stay in the chair for another 15 minutes or so, doing upper body work and some core. And then another 15 minutes doing some leg work and cardiovascular. Okay, let's go to a forward tap with the heels. Good. Now let's bring those legs to the corners. If you've been watching the show and been doing this for a little bit, these are nothing new, this warm-up. Let's go back to the front. Use the arms now. Reach, reach, reach. And to the corners, reach. Back to the front for eight. And to the corners. Eight. Back to the front for eight more. Holding those abdominals in to the corners. Now let's still the legs. Bring the arms up and twist. Twist, just nice and easy. Holding the stomach in. Good, good job. Okay, we're still got a little bit more of the warm up to go. Okay, so take your right knee, just bring it up and around. So we're just warming up the hip flexors. Now let's go the other way for four. Three, two, and one. Other leg in one direction. And then reverse. Four, three, two, and one. Now just kick here, kick. Eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three. We're gonna go back to those knee circles right here. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Let's switch legs. Bring that circle outward. Seven. We'll go back to the right leg just to give it a break. And four more here, sitting up nice and tall still, checking your posture. Let's go back to that right leg in reverse direction. So it's inward now. One, in, two, in, three, and four more. Four, three, two. Trying to keep your upper body really still. Left leg in, inward here. One, good. Two, just do what you can. Three, four, always okay to take a break and start again. Two more, and back to those kicks. Excuse me. Let's do eight more right here. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and back to some twist. Center, twist, center, twist, center, twist. Now extend the arms, twist, center, twist, center. Good. Keeping those hips and legs really still. That's where those play balls come in handy. Sometimes we put them between our knees to keep our hips and legs really still, so we're isolating the core area. Let's do a few more here. Four, three, two, and one. Good, let's take some deep breaths. Inhale and exhale. Good job. Okay, so that's the first part. That's just the warm-up. We're going to take a short break, and we're going to go into some upper body work. You can stand or stay seated. We'll be right back.
Here are a few tips for the Senior Lift Program, preparing to exercise. Do I need to warm up before exercising? The answer is yes. Warming your muscles before an activity increases blood flow to the muscles being used and decreases your risk of soreness and injury. It's also important in preparing mentally. And a couple of things to remember. Warm up for about 10 minutes, and this can include mimicking your planned activity at a slower pace and reduce intensity.
These hands hold tight. These hands love. These hands support. These hands create. These hands save lives. To empower your hands to help make a difference, call the American Heart Association at 877-242-4277 for a CPR class near you. These hands are wise.
So we're back. We're going to do some upper body strength training. And Miyuki is going to stay in a chair to show you that that's an option. Berlinda and I are going to stand. You can decide what you want to do. You can do half and half if you want. I've got 5-pound weights. Miyuki and Berlinda have 3-pound weights. If you have weights at home, use what you have. One, two, whatever is good for you, okay? That rhymed. Okay, so we're going to start with shoulder lifts. So you want your elbows even with your shoulders. And if you're standing and you've been exercising a while, you can put your feet together to make this more challenging. If your balance is a little off, you want to spread your legs a little bit wider to get yourself in a nice stable position, and your knees should be slightly bent, okay? Try to keep your stomach in. And we're ready? Here we go. Up, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now we're going to transition to a bicep curl. One, two, three, four. That gives our shoulders a break. Five, six, seven. Now we're going to go back to that shoulder press. So turn your hands. Here we go. Ready? Up. One. So we'll do two sets of everything if we can. Four, five, six, seven, eight. Pause and lower to bicep curl. Here we go. Ready? One, two. So this is the second set of both. Four, five. And notice my elbows are right into my sides. And eight. Okay, so now we're gonna do some sidearm lifts. So it looks like this. So you wanna be sitting on the edge of your chair if you're in the chair. And then the other exercise we're gonna alternate is this one in the front. Okay, here we go for eight. Eight, seven, six. And you only wanna go as high as your shoulders. Four, three, two, one. Now to the front. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Now back to the sides right here for eight more if you can. Two. Remember to keep your knees bent. Four, five, six, seven. Your shoulders should be getting tired by now. To the front for the last eight. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Good job. Let's put one weight down. And we're gonna do, if you're standing and you're behind your chair, you're just gonna lean on your chair and you're gonna bring your weight up to your chest, and we're gonna just extend it back, tricep extension. If you're in the chair, you're gonna do the same thing, kind of leaning forward, bringing your weight up to your chest, elbows nice and high, and we're just gonna flip it back, okay? Here we go. Back, one, back. Two, we'll go nice and slow with the music. Three, makes it harder that way. Four, back, five, back, six, back, seven, and back. Let's switch arms. Get your body in a good position. You can even be staggered if you want to have one leg behind the other if you're standing. Here we go, ready? Back, one. So you're keeping that elbow high and close to the body. Back, back, and back. How many more? Four more? Back, I don't know. Back, back, one more. Let's go with one more. And then now we've got the right arm again for the second set. Thank God we can switch arms, right? Here we go. Kick back. That's one. And back. And two. And back. How you doing, Mayuki? And back. Four. Back. Five. Back. Six. And seven. One more. And eight. Switch arms. Last time. Second set. Here we go. And back. One. Back. Two. Back. If you want to exercise with people at the Senior Center, we've got a good group. Monday and Wednesdays, we've changed the time to 2:30 to 3:30. Back. Back. Lost count. Let's call that eight. And let's stand up. Put the weight down for a moment. And let's just take a deep breath in. And exhale. And again. Inhale. And exhale. Okay, let's take the weights. Bring them up here again. Palms forward. Knees are slightly bent, holding our stomach strong. We're just going to bring the elbows together. One. Squeeze. If you can touch your elbows, fine. If you can't, that's okay. Keeping your elbows and shoulders in alignment. Four more. Three more. Two more. And last one. Now let's switch this to a different exercise. Bring the weights down here. And what you're going to do is just bring the weights right up with your elbows high and down. That's one. Up, up, and down. That's two. And up, up, and down. And three, up. And really watch your form. If you have a mirror close by, that's four. Up, five, up, up, a little bit faster pace. Six, having a mirror close by to look at your form is really helpful because form is really more important than how many you do. Is that eight? What? It's eight, good, okay, thank you. Let's go back to that first set. What did we do? What was the first set we just did? That's right, I just drew a blank. Here we go, bring those elbows in and out, in and out, in, good. Four more, four, three, takes a village, two, and one. Drop the arms, bring the elbows up, one, two, three, and four. Four more, three, two, and one. Good job. All right. How we doing? All right? Yeah, just roll those shoulders. Take a break if you need to. We've just got a few more minutes of this upper body. Let's do some waist right now, though, just to give the shoulders a break. So your knees have to be bent here, and if you're in a chair, you're still on the edge of your chair. Roll your shoulders back and down, and all we're doing is sliding down and up, down and up, sliding down and up. Down and up. And if you want to bring your weights right to the front of the chair, it might look like this. I don't know if it's comfortable to do it this way. It might be okay. But for me, I think I want to go into the front of the chair a little bit more. If you can stand, better to stand, because it also it's helping your balance. Weight-bearing exercises are good for your bones. Four more. Three more. Two more. And one more. Okay. Now we're going to bend forward, and we're going to do that row. So back like this. Bring your elbows back. So you're forward, your knees are bent, and you're just bringing your elbows back. Let's do eight more right here. Eight. Seven. Six. Your head is supposed to be neutral, so you should really be looking down. And I lost count. Let's stop it. Let's one more. Okay, let's stop there. Come on back up. Let's do those side bends again. So get yourself in that position where your knees are bent, your stomach's in, or you're still on the edge of your chair. Check your posture. Down, up, down, and up. That's two. And three. Four. We having fun yet? What? I didn't hear anybody. Good. Lost count again. Are you counting at home? Let's do one more on each side. Okay. All right. So we're going to go back to that second set of the rows. Okay? So knees are bent, arms are straight, you're bent forward in front of you. Back. One. Back. Two. Back. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven, and last one is eight. All right, let's put the weights down. Let's take a deep breath, and we'll take a break and get a drink of water, and we'll be right back.
Hands can do incredible things. Now they can even help save a life with hands-only CPR. If you see an adult suddenly collapse, just call 911, then push hard and fast in the center of the chest until help arrives. Learn more at handsonlycpr.org.
If you don't clean up your room, the Board of Health is gonna condemn it. You make that face again, it's gonna freeze that way. If you don't get your blood pressure checked, you could have high blood pressure and not know it and die from a stroke.
Okay, we're back again, ready to strengthen our heart with a little cardio and then some leg work. So we're going to start by marching. You always have the chair next to you to kind of lean onto if you need to. That's okay. If you don't need the chair, don't use it. So when we're marching, always your posture, you want your shoulders rolled down and back. Your stomach in. And smile, even if you don't feel like it. It'll change you. So what we're gonna do is out and in. Out and in, out and in. So I'm leading, we're leading with our left foot. Back to regular marching. The next time we're gonna lead with the left foot. Most important is your form. Let's go with the left foot right here. Left, out and in. Sometimes it's harder on the left side. You can also do this in the chair. Back to marching. All right, let's change this to some taps. We're going to start with the right foot tapping forward right here. Good job. The music's a little fast, so just keep your steps small. We're going to go to some kicks. Right here. Kick, kick. And again, check your posture. So we have Zumba starting up this week at the Senior Center, Thursdays at 10. We have yoga Thursday mornings at 8:30. We have exercise Monday and Wednesdays at 2:30. We have a treadmill in the wellness room you can use. We're going to have a second one coming soon. Let's march. Didn't give you a lot of time there, did I? How about some knee lifts? Knee lifts. Good. Let's do eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. All right. We're going to move to the back of our chair. If you need your chair, use it for balance. If you don't, then it's a balance challenge, okay? So we're going to start with bringing the right leg back, as far back as you can get. Get it, so you're on the ball of your foot. So I'm going to turn sideways. I'm hoping you can see that shot on my foot. So what I want you to do is just lower your heel down and up. So that back leg should be straight. Your front leg is bent, but your back leg is straight. And if you're having a hard time, get it back further. Look at the distance my 2 feet are. You want it really far back. Okay? Let's do a few more. So we're warming up the calf. We're strengthening the calf and the shins. Now let's keep it up right here and drop the knee down. That's one. And again, if you don't need the chair, two. It's really a good balance challenge with the idea that you can always grab onto it. Let's do four more. Good. Two more. Okay. Let's bring it forward. Let's go to the other side. Just lowering the heel, coming up. Two. Three. That back leg stays straight. All you're doing is bringing the heel down and back. The knee stays straight. Very good. Very good. Let's do four more. Four. Three. Two. And one. Now keep the heel up. Now you want to drop the knee down. There's one. And you're coming. And you're straight down with your upper body. Two. Three. Four, five, six, seven, and eight. Now, we're gonna put that together, and so we're gonna step back, we're gonna drop down, come up, and then come back to the starting position. And then the left leg, step back, down, up, and start again, okay? We ready? Okay, use your chair if you need to. Step back, down, up. Step back, down, up. That's only one. Step back, down, up. And step back, down, up. That's two. Back, down, up. Back, down, up. That's three. Down, up, back, down, up. That's four. Back, down, up. Back, down, up. Back, down, up. Back, down, up. We've got two more sets, two more on each leg. Here we go. Back, down, up. Back, down, up. One more on each leg. This should get your breathing up a little bit because you're using large muscles. Okay, good. Good job. Okay, let's go do some inner and outer thigh work now. Kind of work the front and the back. So what we're going to do is take a big step to one side. We're going to lean over, come back up. Lean over, come back up. Now when we lean over, make sure your leg, your knee is not over your toe, not like this. It's more sitting back. Sit your hips back, okay? We ready? One, two, three, four. Can also use the chair. Five, sitting back. Six, seven, and eight. Now to give that leg a break, we're gonna go to the other side. Okay, so nice big step over, over, one, back, bring those hips back, two, back, three, back, four, back, five, back, six, back, seven, one more time, and eight, and then back up to the center. Now we're gonna do the same motion, only we're gonna bring it back up every time. So it looks like this, demonstration. Over and one, over and two. So it's step one, two, three, four, okay? If we wanna break it down. So we'll do eight on each side. Step, over, up, one. Step, over, up. It's more of a step back, up, three, step, sit back, up, four, step, sit back, up, five, step, sit back, up, six. So that left leg is straight. Seven, last one, and eight. We've got the other leg to do. Make sure you're breathing. Here we go, ready? Step, sit back, up, one. Step, sit back, up, two. Step, sit back, up, three. Step, sit back, up, four. More. Good job, everybody. Do your best. Two more. Step, back, up, one more. Good job, good job. Let's go up and down with the heel lifts. This could be a balance challenge if you don't use your chair or maybe just one finger on it. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Good job, everybody. We're gonna take a break. And we're going to come back, and I believe it's time for our cool down already.
These hands hold tight. These hands love. These hands support. These hands create. These hands save lives. To empower your hands to help make a difference, call the American Heart Association at 877-242-4277 for a CPR class near you. These hands are wise.
My uncle called, speech all slurred, complaining his arms numb. He called everyone. He even called my daughter Tierra because she's got a year of nursing. Everyone thinks he needs to go to the doctor, including me. So he said, well, will you take me? I'm like, I'm on the road. He goes, I'll wait. Stroke's no joke. If you or someone you love have symptoms of stroke, don't wait. It may be too late. Dial 911.
Okay, we're back. We're going to finish up the show with some stretching, a little bit different than what you're used to. So I'm going to demonstrate onto the side of my chair, but I want you all to be behind your chair so you have something to hold on to. Okay, so we're bringing the right leg over the left. We're going to stretch our IT band. That's the band that runs down your hip. The right leg is bent, the left leg is straight. You're going to inhale up. Exhale over. So you're going to feel this stretch all the way down your side. So really, you got to concentrate on your form here. It's important to have that front leg bent and the back one straight. Now let's bring it back up. Exhale down. Now you've got the chair to hold on to reach up with the other arm. You're going to hold on to the chair. Inhale up. Exhale over. Good. Good. And let's bring your arm up, exhale down. So now we're gonna switch legs. So now your left leg is over your right. Left knee is bent, right leg is straight. Inhale up, exhale over. Here you're just mostly feeling it on the side. You're not going to feel your IT band until we reach up with the other arm, I believe. Now, here we go. Inhale up. Exhale over. Holding onto that chair. Kind of kicking your hip out a little bit. Good job, everybody. How are you doing at home? I hope you're joining us. Inhale up. Exhale down. We do this for you. Now I'm going to go back to the behind the chair. And I'm gonna step back, and we're just gonna stretch the back. All right, so you're stepping way back from the chair, legs are straight, kind of kicking your hips back, arms are straight, and you're just stretching your shoulders and your back, and the hamstrings especially. Now walk in a little bit, walk in one step, and now we're going to round the back and then flatten the back. Okay, so round the back and flatten. Round and flatten. And round and flatten. Good, okay. Let's stand up tall. We're gonna do that runner's lunge. So a nice big step back, kind of like we did earlier. And I just want you to plant your heel back there. I'll turn sideways, maybe you can see better. So your front leg is bent, your back leg is straight, your heel is down, and you're up nice and tall, so you're getting a good hip flexor stretch here. This whole right leg should feel a good stretch. Let's switch legs. So nice big stance, wide stance. Front leg is bent, back leg is straight, and you're up nice and tall. If you can, up nice and tall with that heel planted on the floor. And ideally your toes should be both facing forward. And nice deep breaths. Sometimes we forget to breathe, and we have that shallow breathing that doesn't always work so well. And let's come on back up. And we are going to sit in the chair and finish out our stretching. We'll do a little bit of arm stretches. So let's bring our arms out, open up our chest, take a deep breath in. If you're able to, bring your hands behind you, lace your fingers together, and just open up your chest and stretch your arms. This is okay too. So we're kind of stretching all the muscles that we just worked in this last 45 minutes or so. Okay, let's bring one arm across, stretching the shoulders. We did a lot of shoulder work today. Remember, this shoulder does not want to be way up here. I'm going to press it down. We also work the triceps today, so let's bring this arm right up, touch the back of your neck. If you want to give it a little help, want to push it back a little bit, so we're trying to stretch this muscle right here. All right, let's release that and let's stretch the other shoulder right across. Away from the ear, dropping it down. I hope you enjoyed exercising with us today. Check out the schedule. There's a bunch of other dates and times throughout the month that we're on. You should exercise 3 times a week is really good. If it's not with us on Senior Lift, maybe you could take a walk. Find something else to do. Take the stairs in your building. All right, let's release that. Bring your hand right behind your neck. Elbow goes back, stretching the triceps on the left arm. Even doing some simple exercises while you're watching TV, circling your ankles, circling your wrists. That's always good. All right, let's release that and roll the shoulders. And we're gonna do the ankle circles, and then we're gonna stretch the neck, okay? So just circling. This is what you can do during commercials. And then the other way. And one more time the opposite way again. And reverse one more time. Okay, let's stretch our wrists and then we'll stretch our neck. Just a gentle stretch. And then just flip your hand over and gently push down, trying to get a stretch right in your forearm. Switch hands. I hope you're feeling as good as we do, all warmed up and energized. Maybe gaining a little bit of flexibility. Let's flip your hand over. Okay, let's release that. Just shake it out and relax. We're going to take some deep breaths. We're going to stretch the neck and shoulder area. Okay, so take a deep breath in through the nose. And as you exhale now, I want you to tuck your chin in and drop your head forward. And continue breathing. So you're still sitting tall, you're not leaning forward. You're still sitting tall. The only thing forward is your head. Let's bring it back up on the inhale. And as you exhale, tuck your chin in again, drop your ear towards your shoulder. So pressing your shoulder down, trying to get that stretch from your earlobe all the way down to your shoulder. And continue breathing. And on your next inhale, bring your head up to neutral again. And on your exhale, tuck your chin in again, drop your ear towards the other shoulder. Releasing all the tension that you're carrying. Now let's bring your head up to neutral again. Inhale, exhale, look over one shoulder and back to the center and over the other shoulder and back to the center. And again, you can do this during commercials too, keeping that flexibility in your neck. Again, how about one more time? To the right and center, and to the left and center. Okay, drop your ear towards your shoulder, head goes forward all the way around, and stop here and reverse. So you're just rolling your head back and forth. And bring your head up, and that's it for today. Let's take one last deep breath in. Good job, everybody. We'll see you next time on Senior Lift.